keep him alive, whatever it takes. No excuses, no equivocations. No crying.
What do you mean, keep him alive?
Out there, on those screens, we have another test subject. A man. He will face a series of tests. You have to keep John alive until he makes it through. If he completes all of his tests and John is still breathing, then I will remove your collar and you're free to go.
You're a vital piece of my puzzle, Dr. Tim. A critical part of what could be my final test. Amanda, it's time to start.
Begun. He's out of the box. So?
My 22nd analysis without any medical equipment is that his brain's herniating. He needs to go to the hospital and have an operation to decompress his brain.
Bring your self-centered ass to him. Now you better start fucking paying attention. No one's going to any hospital.
I can't perform miracles. You're giving him painkillers. For a tumor like this, he needs steroids, prednisone.
Oh, good, yeah.
Maybe we could try some corticosteroids, you know, like dexamethasone. Why don't you fucking tell me something that I don't know, you stupid cunt?
The only place that he can get those drugs is in a hospital. Or else he's gonna die.
You are not a good listener. I think you missed the part. That if he dies, you die.
You're asking me to do the impossible.
I'm not asking you. He is. He chose you.
Not me.
Amanda. Our doctor can't do what's being asked of her. If you're threatening her, the rules of our game have been made very clear. You need to abide by those rules.
Sorry.
Is that enough for you? You ready to go to the hospital now? He needs to have an operation.
What do you need?
I need anesthetic for a procedure like this.
Anesthetic? What else?
Even with an anesthetic, LeVay,
anesthetic, what else?
Power drill.
it away. Trust me. Put it away. Leave us alone. Now. I apologize for her behavior.
Amanda, if you really care about John, you won't let me do this to him. You're a smart woman, and you know what's right for him.
I'm sorry. I know it's hard to concentrate when you're surrounded by so many things you could kill me with. Like this axe I saw you looking at. Take it. Please, it's yours. Come on. I go for the neck, but I'm not the brain surgeon. Just do it quietly so John doesn't hear me die. Otherwise, he's likely to get upset, rip off his heart rate monitor. Then, you just have to find the sensor and disarm it so you can walk more than 30 feet out that door without the collar detonating. Or you could try and take the collar off yourself. That could be tricky. Slightest knock in the wrong place could trigger it. I should know. I built it. So? Do you have everything you need?
I have the instruments to cut someone open. I don't have the tools to save a life.
You'd be surprised what tools can save a life.